day is it?
Hey gang, welcome back to Hey Bill, What Day Is It? I know by the number of views I'm seeing for this show that all of you seem to like shows about food. We've done chocolate and cheesesteaks and bacon and corned beef and cabbage, pecan, and many more. The problem is that many of you are doing your best to follow some rather severe dietary restrictions. Some for medical reasons, some for religious reasons, as well as others. Well, this week, we're going to give you a day off from your restrictions because May 11th is National Eat What You Want Day. Every year on May 11th, National Eat What You Want Day sets diets aside for a day of indulgence. It's about having one day a year of eating with no regrets. Whether you love donuts or fast food, today is your day to gratify without feeling guilty. Chili cheese dogs, greasy hamburgers, French fries, potato chips, cake, cookies, candy, ice cream are just a few of the things you can enjoy today without remorse. Decadent food is definitely on the menu today. The saying, everything in moderation, applies to this holiday quite aptly. But remember what Mark Twain said, everything in moderation, including moderation. However, a sample of this and a sample of that has a sure way of satisfying a sweet tooth or a greasy yearning. Need a salt fix? This holiday offers it. How about a crunch craving? Yep, we're sure you can find what you're looking for. Whether it's rich, fried, fast, frozen, baked, or spicy, eat what you want. Some of us have that one irresistible food that we avoid at all costs because we know that if it's in our house, we're going to eat all of it. It's our weakness, our kryptonite. Obviously, my wife's kryptonite is chocolate. Any and all kinds of chocolate. However, today's holiday suggests that we bend to our kryptonite just this one time each year. But as we drop all restraints and go for indulgences, remember, even Superman could only take so much kryptonite. How about those who avoid certain foods for medical reasons? If you're allergic to peanuts, you'll still have to avoid that. If you're allergic to shellfish, you probably want to stick to your no shellfish regimen, or it'll be a large helping of EpiPen for you and a trip to the emergency room. If you're diabetic, please avoid that field trip to the candy store or donut shop. That could do you a lot of damage and perhaps take your glucose meter beyond its limits. Follow your doctor's orders, or you might not live to see another Eat What You Want Day. But for the rest of us, May 11th is a free pass to a day of crazy indulgences. In my mind, I can already see a long caravan headed down the street, hitting every fast food restaurant in town. Other than the obvious reasons, there are other side effects that might be observed. You might be spending more than usual on dry cleaning as you drip grease and ketchup all down the front of you. For others of you, the back seat of your car might start to look like a dumpster with all the bags and wrappers that you've thrown over your shoulder. Some of you might be overly fond of different ethnic foods, such as Mexican. A sudden intake of chilies and cheese and beans might have a collective effect on your digestive system that could be less than pleasant. If you love Chinese food, like I do, you should be able to eat more because you're always hungry 30 minutes after you eat Chinese. I always love to eat Italian food, but I've discovered that carrying on a lengthy conversation with someone is a little difficult after I've consumed large quantities of the garlic that usually flavors the best Italian dishes. Ice cream can become an obsession for a lot of people. Anticipating a trip to Baskin-Robbins or Marble Slab Creamery can send some people into tremors at just the thought of it. Another safety tip, if you hear the ice cream truck coming down the street and you just have to have some, remember to look both ways. Just because we've given you permission to eat it all doesn't exempt you from injuries inflicted by running out in the traffic. Now for those of you who are into both variety and quantity, you can head to the nearest buffet. In Las Vegas, buffets are the standard for stuffing yourself until you burst. you can end up with a huge plate piled high with everything from prime rib to seafood. As you loosen your belt to allow yourself just a little more room, remember that not everything that happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. You just might take home more to Omaha than you had anticipated. Airlines have learned that a plane full of people weighs less going into Las Vegas than it does leaving Las Vegas. The wallets are usually much lighter, however. If you're really into baked goods, you might really pig out on this day. Just remember that your taste may change afterwards. When I was in high school, I got a job at a bakery. When we started, they told us that we could eat as much as we wanted to while we were there. They knew that it wouldn't take us long to eat so much that we would never want to eat a cupcake again. And they were right. Pizza's another food that can really sneak up on you. It's really easy to order a couple of supreme pizzas, and before you know what you've done, you've eaten both of them. Watch out for the other after effects attributed to eating anything you want. Remember going to grandmother's house for Thanksgiving? Everybody pigs out on everything, including the ever-present turkey. The result of this gluttony is usually that everyone succumbs to the Thanksgiving coma and falls asleep in the living room. The culprit blamed for this state is traditionally the turkey, which contains the amino acid tryptophan, which causes sleepiness. That may not be the case in every instance, however. Neuropharmacologist Richard Wortman of the Massachusetts Institute of Technology's Department of Brain and Cognitive Sciences in Cambridge, Massachusetts, said, paradoxically, what probably makes people sleepy after Thanksgiving dinner is dessert. He adds, eating carbohydrates increases brain serotonin in spite of the fact that there's no tryptophan in carbohydrates. Not that it's going to make that much difference. It's not going to make any difference to me. I'm still going to eat it and probably still going to fall asleep afterwards. If you're approaching National Eat What You Want Day from a Jewish perspective, there are good reasons for avoiding certain foods. Those reasons came out of God's covenant with the Israelites while they were wandering in the wilderness. There's a whole list of things that God forbids this people to eat. Some of these were because the animals had been declared unclean. Many of them were just a good idea to avoid. Animals such as snakes and worms were forbidden, as well as clean animals that had been found dead or torn by predators. Pregnant women were not to drink wine. When you look at the list, they just scream out as a good idea to avoid, even today. God gave them this list of improper or not kosher foods in order to maintain the Israelites as holy or approved by God. They were His special people, and these laws helped them maintain that clean or holy state. This was to preserve the Israelites because the Messiah was to come from them. Preserving the Israelites as holy in God's sight was the whole point of this exercise. While many of the laws were dismissed at the Jerusalem Council 50 years after Jesus' resurrection, we can still see that eating roadkill is really a bad idea. Now, I know that even after hearing some of these warnings, most of you are going to really enjoy National Eat What You Want Day and scarf up tons of forbidden foods while the prohibition is lifted for a day. Just remember, though, it's only for one day. I'm Bill Wasore, and this is Hey Bill, What Day Is It? Do your best to enjoy Eat What You Want Day. I'll meet you the day after on the bathroom scale. Have a triumphant day.